Somebody say yoga? Trevor? Michael.
Hey. It's good to see you, man.
Yeah, I bet it is. Of course, I'm not the one that's been resurrected. Ain't this grand, huh?
Yeah, well, I got in a bit of an awkward situation.
You're telling me, bro. Yeah. One of those fake your own deaths to your best buddy, and then run off with the dough, and then live in a big mansion. Awkward situations.
It's one way of looking at it.
Yeah, do you have any other ways of looking at it? Because I am all out.
It was a long time ago, man. I've been in witness protection. I still am.
That's great. That's great. Now let's go. Come on.
All right. You know, I could probably handle this myself. Let's say we grab a beer in a few hours, catch up properly.
I'm good, homie.
She's my daughter, I'll handle it.
Judging by past behavior and the state of the rest of your family, fuck only knows what that means.
Hey, fuck you.
Yeah, you're a model husband and a wonderful parent. I can just tell.
You walk into my home and try to tell me how to run my life. It don't work like that, amigo. It's nice to see you and all, but you stink like piss, you got blood under your nails, and you look like you've been up for what, a week? Who the fuck are you to tell me anything?
I'm someone who knows you, you fucking slippery snake. I know the second I leave you, you'll just go home. We're gonna get your girl from these assholes. You're not abandoning her like you did me and Brad.
Yeah, Brad.
Poor motherfucker. Fucker must have woke up handcuffed to a hospital gurney after that stunt of yours. He still writes to me from the joint, you know.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. So, how you been doing?
Oh, I'm getting by. Aside from the loneliness and heartbreak, of course.
You live in Los Santos?
A few hours away.
Okay. So where?
Sandy Shores. The Alamo Sea.
Ah, I hear it's nice there.
Yeah, it's fucking beautiful. I mean, we ain't got the tennis courts, the golf links, all the pumped-up plastic sluts you're used to out here, but, well, you know, it'll do.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd ask you to stay, but...
Yeah, don't worry, all right? I got somewhere to crash while we work things out. With actual friends.
We got things to work out.
Yes, sirree. Come on! Pace, will ya?
Yes.
Whoa!
us.
Let's find your baby. These spaces are reserved for production vehicles. Come on, you dipshit. Ah, that host, man, he's like any closeted TV presenter. Bitter as fucking vinegar.
Where the fuck are they?
Hello, sir. May I please have your name?
Where the fuck is Tracy Townley, huh? Tracy fucking DeSanta. Fuck, screw that. Where the fuck's Laszlo?
All right. Yeah. That was really
good.
All right. It's the auditions, Fame or Shame, season 14, right here in Vinewood, San Andreas. Coming up next, it's Tracy DeSanta. Judges, Tracy DeSanta. Yes.
Hi.
All right. Tracy's a dancer, but she also likes acting, modeling, and working with children. That's beautiful. You're so original, like a basket full of puppies or a rainbow or a pile of puke.
Oh.
Who are these clowns?
That's my dad and Trevor?
Two dads. Great.
Wow.
Very San Andreas.
What are you guys doing here?
Yeah, what are you doing here?
Okay, I'm back.
Relax, chill, make yourself at home. He's got a little show to do here.
Okay.
3, 2, 1. All right, it's Fame or Shame for Tracy DeSanta. Music!
When I came home last night, you wouldn't make love to me. You went fast asleep.
Yeah.
You wouldn't even talk to
Shake
me.
Shake what your daddy's gave
you,
honey.
I'm so crazy.
The dogs stuff a 20 in this.
Oh!
Fucking do something about this.
That's enough.
Oh! I said that's enough! Hey, I got security! Security!
What'd you fucking
say? Hold
it,
come on, big guy! Come on there!
No!
Fuck!
No!
Come here, you little shit!
No!
Go home right now, Tracy! Come back here! They took our ride, we take their truck.
There! We take the truck!
I know. Biggest score in American history. You and me and the kid and the creep.
Incredible.
Wow, the big one. We did it.
The big one. We're not two-bit hoods anymore. We did it. Shit! Close to a skin joint. You love skin. Tell you what, Mikey, my life now is one long orgy of easy sex, strong meth, and good times with good people, but I miss the old days.
Oh, you do you? What, us, always broke, on the run, crazy shit, the place always covered in snow? You miss that crap?
Yeah, sure. I miss my innocence.
Innocence? You?
Yeah, I miss not knowing the people you like most turn out to be snakes.
Mr. DeSanta, good to see you.
Here we go!
Janked in a motherfucker.
Humanity at its basis.
Cousin Floyd says strip clubs objectify women, but you ain't objects. Hey, you're people.
Yo, what's up?
Ever consider buying or stealing a watch?
What the hell?
Well, gents, we did it.
Damn straight.
Yes, quite a journey.
We robbed the feds, we tricked the IAA, we boosted a huge pile of gold, and we defeated a private army and its billionaire investor. That's the way you retire.
But, most importantly, Frank, is that we learn to not be snakes. You got that?
Yeah, sure.
Because if you learn too much from Michael and not enough from Trevor, then you're doomed. Before you know it, you'll be faking death, stabbing backs, and taking plea bargains.
Yeah, as opposed to eating joggers, smoking meth, and molesting sailors.
Uh-uh. It's not molesting if they're lonely. It's patriotism.
You're not even American.
I am. Fuck you.
Yeah, whatever you say, eh?
Jesus.
I need a bigger TV.
I ain't got time for bullshit.
Fuck me. I had to take out a third mortgage.
No way.
How's it
going?
My
wife rides me so hard I need to buy a saddle that I can't even afford.
I need to get home and get drunk.
I ain't got time for bullshit.
Excuse me.
I'm so tired of moving refrigerator-sized amps. I'm gonna throw my back out.
Whatevs.
The pounders are great.
I hear you.
Come on, man. These young cats is crazy. No?
True that?
I know it's gonna give me the shits, but I need some taco bomb in my mouth pronto.
I wish people would stop calling me for stylist jobs. I'm not a stylist.
It's this town that has the problem. They don't know talent and they
hear it. I help out photographers because I've got that instinct, you know?
Are you still stuck on 4G? Wiz Wireless is the only network offering incredible 9G technology. Yes, that's the 9th generation, featuring the new drone. It's significantly better than the iFruit phone. How do we know that? Because we blatantly ripped off their design and improved a couple of irrelevant features. 9G, discover your future. You can't be the best if you aren't doing 8 things at once on a tiny screen. The drone from Wiz Wireless. Together we're making your life 9 times better. That's the promise of the 9th generation.
Woo! Sweet beans and bacon, that's good. Welcome back. Sorry, I was just finishing a refreshing lager.
Lager, the official beer of fame or shame.
It's a lie. Just followed some poor guy into the loo so he could show him his lager.
Imran, hey, it's been like 5 minutes since you said anything. You're paid to talk, buddy.
I'm here in association with Flowwater. Flowwater.
Hey, let's take a minute for the troops and for disabled people and for sick pets and for ugly people. They suffer the most of all. And speaking of ugly people, is William a pimple on America's ass or a charming gnome in its garden? Fame or shame? Anita.
I think... shame. Which is a shame. It just wasn't there for me.
That's gotta be pretty heartbreaking, buddy. But you're not out of the running yet. Imran!
I just love the exciting variety of toppings available at Up and Atom Burger. Up and Atom Burger. What? Shame. No question.
Two down, there, power ballad boy. Let's talk to the big chief and hear from him, Hugh.
Well, William, you know, you are so ugly. Ugly! Even Laszlo would turn out the lie. And you sing like Jez Torrent's asshole after a curry. Come on, mate. One guy calls you talentless, ugly, and a waste of space on national television, and you cry.
Wow. What are you thinking right now? What's going through your head as those tears are coming down your face, buddy?
I'm just proud of the journey I've been on. Mm-hmm. It means so much to me. Mm-hmm. And my sick brother and our dead dog. Did I mention my mother, Laszlo?
Oh, did I mention nobody cares?
Well, she abandoned me.
Huh. Whoopsie-doo! People are abandoning the show in droves! Our ratings are in the toilet! Somebody do something controversial. Anita, flash your titties!
No!
Have a mental breakdown or something.
Unacceptable! What is this?
Hugh, shoot him. Shoot him in the nuts. I can't lose this gig. I got a mortgage to pay.
When I feel anxiety, I visit Hill Farm.
After my dad got sent to jail, they foreclosed on our farm, too.
Hold on. Wait a minute. Listen, I've still got to vote for William.
Yeah, exactly. All right. We've got one more vote on Fame or Shame. Hugh.
I'm going to vote. Fame. Fame. America needs power ballads sung by top talent with exciting backstories like you. And I'd like to sign you to my record label and make you a star. But first, please, would you do me a favor?
What? Anything? What?
Do the honors, get us out of here, and take him out.
What?
Punch him in the face.
Sorry.
Oh. This has been Fame or Shame, the finals. We'll have more finals next week. Brought to you in association with my Batsu cars and the drone. Just like the iFruit phone that lets you look down on people in a whole new way. We'll see you on the next finals of Fame or Shame. Jesus, sweet donkeys.
Don't miss the next episode of Fame or Shame, the finals. Talent show.
Of course. What else would you drive? How about this? Just like old times.
So, Mike, I should probably say...
What?
Well, maybe I shouldn't have reacted the way I did. I mean, let's be honest, Brad was a dick and things were getting out of control. You had the kids and you'd already missed so much of their growing up, I could feel like I was losing you, you know, so I pushed you harder. I thought that was how to keep you in the game, and I didn't want to lose you. I've said that already, haven't I? Well, it was gonna blow up, man. We all knew it was, and I guess... I guess I'm happy you made it out alive, and with enough money to make sure your kids became total, complete nightmares.
Hey!
I mean, if you'd taken less, you know, a couple million, they'd only be dicks! But with your savings, you were able to truly, completely ruin them. Selfish, soft, without any skill. They got it all. You've provided for their future.
Ha ha! That's funny, because it's true. It's also kind of sad.
Hey, bro, they're sweet. Kinda.
Brad was a dick, wasn't he?
Oh, yeah. He was. Bless him.
There's a skin joint around here. I'll go with you if you promise not to crack wise about it. T, it's me. You up to anything? Want to hang out?
Of course, Mikey. I'd love to.
Cool. I'll swing by.
Hello.
Hola.
Shotgun, not driving. How about this? Just like old times.
Tell you what, Mikey, I can tell why you like Vinewood so much.
Oh, I know. It's fantastic, isn't it? I mean, I don't know. I'm just sort of happy here, even when I'm also really depressed.
No! Sugar tits, you like it because it's just like You, plastic and fake. The world champion of phoniness has come to the world capital of fakeness. And what a surprise! You fit right in.
Sure. Whatever you say, T. I'm a fake, you're real. It's cool.
Oh, don't get all passive on me, Cupcake. No one likes being called out on their bullshit, but it's true.
Of course it is. Whatever you say. Whatever you say.
What, Mikey? America needs us right now.
Really? America needs a couple of middle-aged bank robbers running amok? Really? How'd you figure that out?
Place is falling apart. They can't make good movies. They can't fight modern wars. They can't pass good laws. Everyone hates each other with a passion. But thanks to people like you and me, at least the country still sets standards in robbery.
This is 911. What emergency service do you require? Thank you. Paramedics are en route to your current location. This is 911. What emergency service do you require? Thank you. Police officers are en route to your current location.
is full of crazy people, bro.
I know. It's a miracle you took so long to get here.
Ha! Not like good crazy. Kill people and eat them crazy. I mean, like, I don't understand these people at all crazy.
Oh, you mean sane.
If being void of anything real and substantial and only caring about the meaningless surface of things is sane, then yes, that.
I gotta tell you, you're really rocking that outfit, bro. Where you get it?
Let's go.
Where are we?
You go easy on it.
Thank you. Oh my, you saved me. Hey. No.
Hey, I said easy. Oh, come on, give the guy a break. I will get out of this shit. Ha-ha! In bed with the Bureau and a new running buddy.
Yeah, he's more of a protege.
Yeah, what, you gonna teach him to be old before his time?
Yeah, to never grow up.
That seems like a good kid. Michael, look at this, huh? New city, new set of problems, but the idiots, they stay the same.
Yep, I guess. All right, Trevor, I'll see you later.
Oh, you better believe it, buddy.
Guys, you run out of batteries, huh?
I didn't mean anything by it, all right?
Oh, yeah? Well, that little girl sat on my lap when she was 2 years old, and I swore to God that I would rip the fucking skin off anyone who fucking wronged her.
Look, I'm just a dumb A-list celebrity trying to entertain America, okay? I got a lot of stuff going on right now, dude, besides you trying to kill me. Now, I got multiple sexual harassment lawsuits, plus I'm an addict, all right? And I've relapsed. I can't stop jacking, dude. I jack it in traffic.
What's your talent, huh? I mean, aside from loving sex.
Dude, haven't you seen my show? It's not live, it's not funny. That's my genius, I got no fucking talent.
You clearly ain't being humble, T. You proved your point.
This is your daughter. You should be wanting to rip the fucking ponytail off the back of this guy's head. And you! Pants off.
Okay.
There you go. All right.
What are you doing
now? I want you to dance sexy, celebrity,
I mean, I need music, or...
Are you trying to fucking annoy me, huh?
I'll dance.
Good. All right, all right. Now drop it like it's hot, all right? I want to see you get nice and low. Come on, lower, lower, come on.
Oh, please don't kill me, okay? I'm supposed to be on a magazine cover next week.
All right, come on, get off. Take off, go, now. Before I change my mind.
I got it all on my camera, you fucking pussy. The world's gonna see your shit.
I'm going home.
How the fuck did you do it without me for 9 years, huh?
What? Tracy's getting another tattoo.
No, oh God, no. That Laszlo guy's there.
Laszlo, that asshole. What's he want?
It's Tracy that wants something. She wants to get back on Fame or Shame after you and Uncle T cut her cameo short.
Well, maybe we ought to help her out with that.
Maybe we ought to.
Hey, let me ask you. Back there with your mom. That went okay, didn't it?
Anything that ends with Fabian's burst eardrum is more than okay with me.
Yeah, I mean with me and your mom.
I think it's an important first step in, like, the direction of okay, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, yeah, I know what you mean.
I think they're in here.
You asshole!
Holy fuck! I'm looking for something hip that...
You know, says I'm capable of violence, but I'm awesome in the sack. So listen, babe, if you want to make it in Vinewood, you got to do whatever it takes. Even if whatever it takes is a depressed borderline alcoholic who hosts the third most popular talent show amongst the 40-year-old female demographic.
So you'll let me on the show if I blow you?
Yes. And if you could wear some black lipstick, the little guy loves the goth vibe.
Oh.
Whoa.
Laszlo.
Dude, that was entirely out of context, bro.
Jim, you find the Inkslinger, sit on him. Laszlo here is going to have a little cosmetic work done.
No, please.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Stay put, you lame-ass Mark.
Sure, kid.
What? Ow! Are you popping a fucking tent over here? You fucking you fucking prick! Jesus! Ow!
Oh, ho, that looks purty. Here, let's get rid of this.
Oh, my God! Papa Bear! What's Daddy Number Two gonna think about this?
Let's not get him involved.
Let's do... Are we gonna match? Let's solve this like men, and we'll use the same position! Get off!
How about I draw those three little pubic hairs on here, too? There we go. Oh, that's nice.
You got like a camera phone or a mirror?
Oh, yeah, I'll get you a mirror. Smash you upside the head with it.
Fuck this, man.
Snip, snip.
Oh, this is a real one-stop shop. What are you doing? Oh, no, that's my signature, my ponytail. Now I gotta get extensions.
No, what you gotta get is my daughter, whatever she wants.
Yeah, without sucking on your piddle stick.
Look, okay, guys, that was a joke. I'm a clown. I'm a sad, lonely little clown.
Hey, you're gonna put her on your show, and you're gonna make sure she looks good.
Look, okay, I got a lot of juice in this town, but I mean, I'm not a miracle.
Just do it!
Yeah.
All right.
All right, Trace, let's go. We gotta get to the therapist.
What?
So, I'll, like, call you or something, okay? Bye.
If there's ever a family that needs therapy, my ponytail. How do I look? It's not good, is it?
From the heart. Judges, I have to say, I'm thinking if you go the wrong way on this, it could be the end of a lot of promising careers. All right, we're gonna go to commercial.
Wait, wait, hear me out!
No more talking!
Good tea?
Never better, amigo.
Good.
Franklin?
Ah, he'll be here. Franklin.
Hey, what's up?
I assume you got him?
Ooh, safe and sound. Ain't that right, buddy?
Hey, my bad, homie. I picked C. Ain't that a bitch?
You know, Devin, the way I see it, and hey, I'm no intelligent businessman like you, but the way I see it, there's two great evils that bedevil American capitalism of the type that you practice. Number one is outsourcing. You paid a private company to do your dirty work for you, and then you underpaid that company because you thought you were big enough and bad enough that you didn't have to play by the rules. Oh, number two. Offshoring your profits.
Offshoring?
Oh, it's horrible. You wouldn't want to be sent offshore just to save a little money, would you, T?
No.
Franklin?
I wouldn't.
Oh, no, I ain't going nowhere.
No, see, but we know your opinions on the matter, Devin. Keep your problems the fuck out of America, huh?
In this instance, when he puts it like that, it makes sense.
Of course it does. Hey, Devin. Goodbye, my old friend. Thanks for all the advice.
Bye-bye.
So now what?
Now we keep a low profile and get on with our lives.
As friends.
Well, do I have a choice?
No, not really.
All right, then. As flawed, awful, totally uncomfortable, and poorly matched friends. Absolutely.
Oh, that's perfect. Then we can get back to the kind of capitalism we practice.
Shit, I don't know how much more better that is than Devin's kind.
Ooh, hypocrisy, Franklin. Civilization's greatest virtue.
Jesus, your therapist has a lot to answer for.
I know, I still hate myself. But hey, at least I know the words for it now.
Yeah, but I hate you, and I know the words for it. So does that mean I don't have to go to therapy?
Look, man, you two motherfuckers terrify me of that middle age. I'm good.
You're right to be afraid, Franklin.
Yeah.
Be very afraid, Franklin. Tell you one thing, T. I'm getting too old for this nonsense. Oh.